We're getting word of a population explosion of iguanas on Marco Island. We've reported it's happening in Cape Coral. NBC2's Alexis Santos is on Marco, working to find out why the sudden spike there.
You can't put up a fence high enough to hold off an iguana.
And believe Carl Kepford, he's tried.
It was clear they were getting through this fence, so I put up some smaller screen, thinking that would keep them out better, but they just climb over the fence.
He's one of several people who live on Marco Island who say they're fed up with what seems to be a booming iguana population.
It's kind of a pain in the neck.
It was frustrating because, again, we've spent a lot of effort trying to set up our vegetable and herb garden, and then it's destroyed in two nights. So we're pretty unhappy about that.
Not only do they destroy gardens and vegetation.
They were defecating all over the seawall, all over my dock. They got inside the boat, did the same thing in there.
Marco Island has an iguana trapping program that they plan to beef up in the new year. But for the time being,
We try to do what we can.
When we chase them, they'll jump into the canal and they just swim to the other side of the strait. And then next day, they're right back again.
Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission recommends removing the iguanas from your property or getting a trapper to do so. They're an invasive species, so FWC does not allow releasing them in other areas.
There isn't a great solution.
In Marco Island, Alexis Santos, NBC.